And I wonder if we'll see another one broken tonight. Steve Cram's mark. The Bislett Stadium is known throughout the sport as the world record track. It's been the venue now for 50 world records over the years. And I wonder if Steve Cram's record is about to fall to this man, and he could be about to make it 51. Nouredine Morsali, just 23, from Algeria, the world champion indoors and out over 1,500 metres, and he already holds the world record for the metric distance, previously held by Steve Cram, and now, as you've heard, chasing Cram's record for the classic mile. It's a brilliant field, as you would expect, in one of the big, prestigious races of any athletics year. 17 men here altogether, and they include runners of the calibre of Fermín Cacho, the Spaniard, the Olympic champion, and also Abdi Bili, the Somalian, the former world champion. Cram and Seb Coe and the man alongside me, Steve Ovett, have all ensured that the world mile record has remained in Britain for the past 14 years. So the 1993 Dream Mile gets underway. Four laps of the track, and Oslo's weather nowhere near as kind as usual tonight. Remember, it's almost 11 o'clock at night here in Norway, and it's very, very cold and windy. Lewis Johnson of the United States and the Kenyan David Kiptu, the designated pacemakers here. But Morsali is a committed front runner, and if the pace slackens, then he will be brave enough to take it on himself. The first mark to look out for at 440 yards, well, Cram's first lap time when he broke the world record here was 57.5.
Well, the pace is fast. Morsali in third spot there is having trouble to keep up with the pacemakers. We'll just have to wait and see what they go through in. 55 seconds, it's very fast. Morsali probably on about the right type of rhythm. Cacho just behind him, I think he's maybe running a little bit too fast for his own ability at the moment. But the rest of the people challenging him really are way, way back in the pack. I'd have expected more of a challenge for some of these athletes, but they're letting him go somewhat.
The two pacemakers still out in front. Johnson of the United States, and then the Kiptu of Kenya. But Morsali, the Algerian, well in touch in third place. Then the Olympic champion Cacho of Spain, all in red, in fourth. And they've already got a sizable gap over the next men. 253, the American Jim Spivey. When Cram broke the world record 8 years ago, his time at the two-lap marker was 154.9, and they're inside world record pace again.
Well, they're inside that world record pace, but don't forget that when Cram broke the world record, his last lap was an incredible 53 seconds. I can't see anybody producing that off at this type of pace. The only way that they can produce a world record now is to keep the rhythm going, keep working against the pain. And that's exactly what they're doing. He's now, Morsali is going past the pacemaker, and that's what he's got to do. No pacemaker can really take you more than 1,000 metres at the right rhythm. And Cacho, I do him a discredit, is still hanging on in there to Morsali. He really is working really hard. The Brits there, I think, Strangen is in about seventh place, and Cram well off the back at the moment. And we can't really see where the others are. There's such a chasing pack there.
When the world record was set by Steve Cram here, his time at the bell was 2:53.3, and then he produced, as Steve Ovett has said, that sensational final lap. So Morsali is on target. Cacho pushing him hard. Spivey still running very well in third place. But it's Morsali now, the little Algerian, the man who, it has been predicted, will be the Said Owita of the 90s. The man who, it is predicted, will rewrite the record books in the years to come. He already has Steve Cram's 1500 metres world record. Is he about to get the mile record and break Britain's stranglehold on that particular crowd? The world record time, 3:46.32. It has stood for 8 years. Britain has held it for 14 years. But Nouredine Morsali has just failed to topple Cram's mark, and Britain at least has that point of pride. We still hold the world record.
And a fine run by Steve Cram too, who came into third place, and I've got him in 3:52.3, so that really is a great return to form.